just consult your doctor, try to go and do some checkup, let them check you up to see if it is not something health issue. Hello guys, welcome to my channel. And if you have not subscribed to my three YouTube channels, you better pause this video to subscribe to my three YouTube channels. This very one, Freedom Beauty, Freedom Styles, and the Freedom Life, because I have three YouTube channels. And then I will try to put the other two YouTube channels in the description box below. And then don't forget to click the notification button so that you will be notified anytime I upload a new video on this my YouTube channel. I usually upload on this channel frequently, and then I don't want you to miss my great videos on this channel. Also want to remind you guys that I am not selling Freedom Styles Magic Hair Growth Oil. And then I will also put the details in the description box below for you to order Freedom Styles Magic Hair Growth Oil. If you have something you want me to discuss on this my YouTube channel, don't forget to DM me. I will put my email in the description box. And if you also want me to hide your name, just put Freedom Styles Hide My Name or Freedom Beauty Hide My Name, and I will hide your name. A lady emailed me, and then she said that some years back her natural hair was really very nice, long and healthy. And then 2 years back she started using wigs. She started putting on wigs. She started ordering wigs online, putting on different wigs and all. She said after putting on wigs for 2 years, and then she's totally bored, and which is true because I saw the pictures she sent. Damn, I appreciated you sending me your pictures to see. And I really know the condition you are passing through. I know how it is. Just seeing yourself, you can't like go somewhere without putting on a wig. And she asked if it is okay for her to order my oil, if my oil will grow back her hair. And I was just like, madam, I can't tell you 100% that my magic hair growth oil will grow back your hair, because it seems like she's not having something called alopecia. The pictures, it seems like no hair will ever grow there, or else she will like just go and do surgery. There is no harm in trying. I would also advise you to try out my oil if you want to try out my oil. But I am not guaranteeing you or telling you 100% that my magic hair growth oil will just grow back that baldness. But you can give a try, because my oil is great. The good side of wig is if your hair is not done and you are going somewhere, you just want to still look cute, you can just like grab one of your wig, put it on, and you will look good, and nobody will notice or nobody will know that your hair is not done. That is the good side of wig, and which is very very nice. And if you also, you save money. And then just imagine if you order a wig that costs $350, and then you usually braid your hair maybe once in a month, $100. Just let me guess. If you are having one wig and then you really care for the wig, and the wig is really quality human hair, and you are caring for the wig, you can have the wig for more than 3 or 4 years. Depends on how you take care of the wig. If you are taking care of your wigs in a proper way, your wigs will last longer. And I want to advise women that usually put on wig every single day. And I know I'm a YouTuber, and I also have hairstyle YouTube channel. Guys, I know a lot of people will think because I do hair videos and I have a lot of wigs and I have a lot of hair extensions, some people will be thinking Freedom Styles will be putting on wig almost every day. Guys, I don't do that. I don't usually put on wig. If you see me having wig on, it's either I am about to film a YouTube video, or I am going somewhere that is very important. Maybe I just want to look good occasionally. I don't usually put on wig every single day. If I do all back cornrows, or maybe if I am going to work and I'm having just upper cornrows, like braided down with my natural hair. I will try to tie my hair with a scarf, just wrap my hair with a scarf. I will just allow my hair to have a breath instead of just putting on a wig. There are different kinds of wigs. Is it that just normal wig, no closure, no lace, just like oldie days wig? And then closure wig that you will be having something like a lace at the front that you can part. That one is called lace closure wig. Frontal wig. A frontal wig will cover all your edges like this. It might be maybe 6 by 13, something like that. Front like this. That one is frontal wig. 360 wig is like the lace we just cover round. It's like a circle lace. And then full lace wig. That one is just everything lace. A lot of people normally love to choose frontal wig just because they can do a lot of styles, maybe do front bun or just have everything, flip everything back. And then front lace wig, the disadvantage of front lace wig is if you want to be able to style your front lace wig, you must apply something like glue. And then when you apply your glue on your edges and you place the wig, if you are not careful or if you don't really know how to remove frontal wig in a perfect way, you will end up losing hair on your forehead, like on your edges. You end up losing a lot of hairs. And then if you continue doing this, doing the method for just 1 month, I promise you, you will be totally bored. Don't use glue to glue down your frontal wig always. Try to maybe manage your wig. You can sew in an elastic band. The method of elastic band is good. Even if you are not to use glue, if you have that elastic band, if you sew in an elastic band to your frontal wig, you can be able to use that elastic band to secure the frontal wig at the back, and then the frontal wig will lay perfectly at the front. And you can comb a little bit of baby hairs out, like pluck out a little bit of baby hairs, and you trim the applied glue. It will still be looking realistic instead of just applying glue anytime you are putting on frontal wig. And then why I found a closure wig helpful is just that the lace is only here, and then it's easier, it's more manageable than frontal wig. And then I will also advise, you know, there are some people, if they are ordering wigs, they will order wigs with combs. Try and give yourself, experiment yourself for 2 months. Be pinning, use that combs to secure your wig in a particular place. Make sure you are not changing the place. Make sure you are placing the combs in a particular place. You will see how your hair, how you will lose a lot of hairs in that place, in that particular place that you are putting the combs. Even if you are to put on wigs, try and avoid using combs, using the combs to secure your wigs, because very, very sensitive to our hair. I don't usually use combs to secure my wigs. Even if I am having wigs that are having combs, I will just leave the combs. I don't usually use the combs to secure my wigs. I will just sew in an elastic band. I will be using the elastic band to secure my wig instead of using combs. Advice for you ladies is just try to also protect your hair whenever you are having wig on. Protect your hair first before putting on a wig. Buy a good oil, hair oil. Use it to rub your, moisturize your scalp, your edges, the ends of your hair, and then before you will put on a wig. Don't think putting on a wig will just protect your hair. It will protect your hair if you protect your hair before putting on a wig. If you are back from work, remove your wig, allow fresh air to penetrate on your scalp. And then for people that usually sleep with wigs, I don't know how you guys does it, or I don't think I can sleep with wig. I can't. I can't sleep with wig. But people that normally sleep with wigs, you guys are trying so much. And then I would advise you to follow these steps and then see if your hair will be back. Just give yourself time, maybe something 5 months. Don't put on a wig. Just like allow fresh air to penetrate on your scalp whenever you are around. Try to moisturize your scalp or before putting on the wig. And if you see nothing is being done, and then just consult your doctor. Try to go and do some checkup. Let them check you up to see if it is not something health issue. And then avoid baldness. It's not good to be bald. Hair is the beauty of a woman. Care for your ovary hair, and then also care for wigs. I'm not telling you not to care for your wigs. Care for your wigs, but make sure you take care of your natural hair or you take care of your relaxed hair before you will care for wigs. Putting on wig is nice. It's very easy. It's handy, but it's better to also care for your ovary hair. And then I usually care for my hair. I love my hair more than my wigs. As you guys are seeing now, I am having a wig on, and this very one is even frontless, but I preferred to do center part because I don't usually love to apply glue on my forehead or on my edges. And I also want you to advise this lady, and I hope I answered your questions, and I hope I also give you some tips you can try. And then thank you guys for watching this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my 3 YouTube channels. I also try to put details in the description box below for you to order Freedom Styles Magic Hair Growth Oil. I hope you guys enjoyed this video like as I enjoyed filming it. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you guys in my next one.